Hello everyone, welcome to this tutorial. Today we are going to learn how to use the pinning functionality in Linearity Move. Let's get started. When I first open the app, I'm going to see the home screen. To create a new document, I click the plus button. Here, I can pick the resolution of my new document or import an existing file. I can import a file from Curve, Linearity's design tool, or connect to Figma and import a design from there. I'm going to select this Curve file and hit the Import button to enter the Scene Builder panel. I simply select and drag one of the artboards to the Scene Builder line at the bottom of the panel. When I'm done, I click the Import button. Here's a text layer. If I move this layer outside of the canvas, I can see that there's only one keyframe added to the timeline. With just one keyframe, there is no animation created. If I press the pin button, I enable a feature called pinning. This feature highlights a segment of the timeline between two pins. This feature is very useful to quickly determine the start and end point of my animation. The pins serve as anchor points for the state of my object. I move the playhead at one of these points, and if I move my object now, it will automatically create two keyframes on the timeline. In this position animation, one end is based on the new position I gave to my text layer. The other end is automatically added based on where the object was positioned before I moved it. The end result is to create a transition between this point and this point. And that's where the pinning actually comes in and becomes useful. I select the other text layer and change the position and opacity. This time, I've created two transition types on the same object thanks to pinning. I do the same thing on the third text layer, but moving it from the opposite direction. I can select multiple objects and take advantage of pinning to apply the same animation to all of them. I select all the icons, including the cursor, and turn down the opacity. Like this, I create an animation for all the objects between the start and end point marked by the pins. I can move the pair of pins together to define different start and end points on the timeline. I can also move just one pin at a time. I can drag a pin individually, or if I want to be more precise, I click on one of the thumbnails, like this, and the pin will snap to the location of the thumbnail. When I've defined the new start and end point of my new animation, I move the playhead to the start point of the pinning segment. I select the MacBook and move it outside of the artboard from the bottom. I also rotate the object 30 degrees. Once again, I've created an intro animation for this object in just a few clicks, all thanks to pinning. I can move the segment a bit further on the timeline and create a pause between one animation and the other. I want the cursor to move from one side of the artboard to the cube in the corner. If I move the object, I am adding a keyframe in the middle of the timeline, which connects to the last keyframe related to this object. The result is not what I expected, and the object is not moving the way I want it to. To fix that, I activate first pinning. I place the playhead to the end of the segment. I select the cursor and move it to where I want it to arrive. Like this. And with this technique, I was able to create a pause between the previous animation and the next one. The pins anchor both the start and end point of the segment. Here's what happens if I add a keyframe in the middle of the segment. I bring the playhead to the middle and select my object. I change the size of the cube. This time, three keyframes appeared on the timeline. The start keyframe, the middle keyframe, and the end keyframe. The start and end keyframes will have the same value, since they are based on what the object looked like before I made the changes in the middle. This is a useful trick to create a back and forth animation in just one click. I repeat this trick on the other icon, and this time I change the rotation of each object. With pinning, I can also highlight a bigger area. This time, I am going to cover the entire length of the animation. I bring the playhead to the start and change the size of the background elements. And with this, my animation is complete. When I'm ready, I can export my animation by clicking File on the top left corner and select Export. Here, I can preview my animation one last time before exporting it. Thank you for joining me today. I hope you found this tutorial useful. You can learn more about Linearity Move and animation from the Learn tab on the home screen. Let's bring our stories to life with Linearity Move.